Follow-through and overlap goes hand in hand. They coexist. What it means is any secondary object which is attached to the primary one will follow the path of the primary object, and its motion will overlap the motion of the primary one. Like in this animation planning, you can see how the tail of the squirrel follows the path of its body, and the action is delayed a little bit, and when the squirrel stops, the tail still comes forward and stops a little bit later than the primary body. It settles into its position. In physics, this is the result of inertia. Like when we are sitting in a bus and the bus suddenly stops, our body still is moving forward, and we overlap the action of the bus and then settle down. Without follow-through and overlap, the entire object, even though it has separate parts, separate body parts and separate elements, the entire object feels very stiff if we don't break down the motion of each element. But if we do, then the action is much more realistic, fluid, and is very interesting. Like here you can see in motion design, if we can just get away with animating the whole object on its own, but if we just break down a little bit of motion, it adds a lot of interest to it and a lot of detail as to motion design and motion animation. For example, let's take the same bouncing ball that we did before. And let's say if this squirrel will have a tail, a piece of cloth or a tail attached to it, and how would that tail really react? Okay, so let's just create the tail first. You can rename this layer as tail, and you can parent it to the ball. And right now, if we do just this, the tail is there, but it's stiff, right? It doesn't have any animation to it, and this doesn't feel natural at all. So what we have to do is add follow through and overlap. So the tail will follow the motion of this ball, which is this curved motion, okay, this bouncing motion, and we should make it follow. So if there are three joints in the tail, we have to break the animation of those joints. Okay, I'm sorry, I'll have to key the stroke, you know, the path of this. Right now at this pose, what you have to do is we have to delay and make it follow the path of the ball. Alright, so we already have fluid motion, and when it hits in this, then the ball comes down and then goes up. So we have to make the tail follow its path. Alright. Okay, so already you can see how the tail is broken up, you know, and how the motion is being delayed. Be mindful of the path that it is traveling on, and make sure which joint will lead first and which will lead second, you know. Okay, so I guess I'll just speed up through the process. Now you can see how the tail is following the path of the bouncing ball, and now it is much more organic. You can compare it to obviously compare it to the previous one where the tail was just a stiff rod and it was not organic at all. Now we have broken up the joints and made it follow the path of the ball, and it overlaps the action of the ball because the bouncing action on the ball happens first and then one or two frames later the tail follows. Okay, so this is how overlap and follow through works. It could work with an antenna. When the car stops, the antenna wobbles front and back to settle after a little time. It can be used on clothes, because when we are running and we suddenly stop, our cloth can still go forward and then settle down. Okay, so I guess this has cleared up how follow through and overlap action can enhance our motion and break down the action into one object, you know, into the separate elements of that object.